alternative proteins. How will we eat in the future? From vegan meat alternatives to the use of technologies, such as precision fermentation and cell cultivation to produce food. That's what we're talking about.
Hello,
I'm Micah, and I'm a food technologist at Krones AG.
Hello. Hi, I'm Alex. I'm an engineer at Steinecker GmbH, and I'm responsible for engineering in the new food division.
And today we've swapped our offices for a kitchen, because food is more of an emotional topic, and we want to talk about the food of tomorrow. And here's a short movie about it.
Simply eating? Not at all. Food has it all. It keeps us healthy. And food is, above all, an emotional thing. It stimulates our senses. Freshness that you can hear. Delightful in smell and taste. Food makes us happy, strengthens the community. We all know that our diet is changing. The type of protein sources in particular will change drastically over the next few decades. This is the only way to ensure that the growing world population can continue to be supplied with vital nutrients while at the same time conserving existing resources. The solution? Alternative proteins, new food. And this is being researched and worked on worldwide, also at Krones AG.
That was a good introduction to our topic today. We mainly have three components in our balanced diet. These are complex carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. When it comes to alternative proteins, we have a few examples with us today.
Exactly. All proteins in general. When we talk about proteins, we're basically talking about animal proteins. We have meat, fish, eggs, milk, quark, and other dairy products through to cheese. Mushrooms are also protein-rich foods, but we can also utilize plant proteins. These are found in soybeans, peas, beans and lentils, for example. What do you have over there, Micah?
Exactly. These are also vegetable proteins, but already further processed. We have tofu or tempeh here, for example. And here's another good example. This is soy mince, which can be used as a meat alternative or meat substitute. And it's not just as a meat substitute that this is relevant, but also as a milk substitute. And we can also process soybeans or oats.
Exactly, because if we look at oats, for example, cereals also have proteins in them, and we can use these by processing them into an oat drink, for example. We at Krones now distinguish between these three major areas. One is the area of vegetable proteins and plant technology for vegetable proteins, isolates or extracts. Then there's the area of fermentation-based products, which includes mushrooms, for example, or cell-cultivated meat from industrial production.
Exactly. And the aim of this is that we can see that some of the proteins we have today consume a relatively large number of resources, and that we can generate an efficient process by conserving resources and using the water and energy we have available sparingly.
That's right, because we at Krones are a machine and plant manufacturer. We don't produce the food to sell it in the end, but we produce the lines to produce the food. And in this area, we think holistically, which is in our DNA. We also think about energy efficiency, we think about water efficiency, and we also think about raw material efficiency in the production of these foods.
Exactly. And that's how we find solutions that go beyond tomorrow, so that we can ensure that we have a balanced diet on our tables in the future and can produce alternative proteins and foods to protect the planet.
Yes, and we haven't just been doing this since yesterday. So Krones has been responsible for the entire field of food technology and food plant engineering and a supplier to this market for decades. And we're now using this expertise from various subsectors to provide this new food market with lines and machines and process engineering concepts.
Exactly. And none of this is rocket science. For example, next time we meet, let's make an oat drink together. It's just like on an industrial scale, only here in the kitchen.
Great. I'm looking forward to it.